So we will be taking a look at introductory part of wastewater engineering, and we will be taking some explained multiple choice questions to get acquainted with the terms such as sludge, sewerage, waste, then refuse, garbage, and some basic terminology involved in wastewater engineering. So without wasting any time, let's go to question number one, which is: sanitary engineering deals with fill in the blank of waste, and the options are collection, conveyance, treatment, disposal, and all of the above. See, when we are talking sanitary engineering, we are dealing with collection, conveyance, that is transportation, treatment, as well as ultimate disposal. Okay, that's why all of the options are correct. Sanitary engineering means collecting the waste from point source, transporting it, and then treating the waste, and finally disposing it off. Okay, so let's go to question number next, which is: the term sanitary sewage includes. What does sanitary sewage include? Do it include domestic sewage or industrial waste, both of the above, or none of the above? Let's see. See, the term sanitary sewage includes domestic as well as industrial waste. Okay, waste from household, community, domestic waste, and industrial waste combined to make what? Sanitary sewage. Okay, let's go to question number next. Refuse. It consists of waste in the format of: is it solid, liquid, semi-solid, or all of the given formats? Let's find out. Refuse consists of waste in the format of solid, liquid, semi-solid also. That is, any rejected or discarded material in any form, whether it is solid, liquid, or semi-solid, is called as refuse. Whatever we are letting go, whatever we are rejecting or discarding, is called as refuse. Okay, then state whether the following statement is true or false. Garbage has more moisture content than rubbish. Let's see. See, when we are saying garbage, it consists of mostly organic waste, and organic waste such as vegetable have very much very high moisture content. And when we are talking the term rubbish, it is made up of waste or discarded material such as papers are there, packing boards are there, cardboards are there, rugs are there, which are mostly dry. That is, they have low moisture content and they are highly combustible. That's why when we say garbage has more moisture content than rubbish, the statement is true. Okay, let's go to question number next. Which of the given is most combustible? Is it sludge or garbage or rubbish or sewage? Let's find out. See, when we are saying sludge, it is the waste from bathrooms and kitchen. It consists of more than 95% water. Then garbage. Garbage has vegetables and other discarded material which is high in moisture content. When we are saying sewage, it is nothing but wastewater. Sewage is what? Wastewater. The term water is there. Okay, that's why moisture content will be very much high. It will not be combustible. Then comes rubbish. Rubbish contains all the discarded material which is highly combustible. That's why out of the given options, rubbish is highly or most combustible. Then, sludge is wastewater from. Where do we obtain sludge from? Is it bathroom kitchen waste or industrial waste or manufacturing plant waste or all of the above? See, when we say sludge, we are referring to wastewater which is received from bathroom, basin, and kitchen sink. Okay? It is not industrial or manufacturing plant wastewater. That's why the correct answer is sludge is wastewater received from bathrooms and kitchen. Then, state whether the following statement is true or false. Domestic sewage excludes human excreta and urine. Let's find out whether it is true or false. See, when we are saying that domestic sewage excludes human excreta and urine, it is false, because domestic sewage contains all the wastewater which is generated after domestic application, after the use of water for domestic application, and it does include human excreta and urine. That's why when we are saying that domestic sewage excludes human excreta and urine, it is false. Then Statewater, the following statement is true or false. Industrial wastes can be unsuitable at conventional treatment plant. Let's find out if it is true or false. See, when we are saying that some industrial wastes are really unsuitable at conventional treatment plant, the statement is true. Because many plants, many manufacturing plants or industry do generate some complex inorganic material or waste which are not proper, which are not suitable for treatment, for their treatment at conventional treatment plants. That's why we need a separate industrial waste treatment plant in such specific kind of industrial waste. That's why saying that industrial waste can be unsuitable at conventional treatment plant is true. Then the question is, night soil contents, do it contain industrial sludge or human excreta or garbage, or do it contain all of the above? Let's see. See, when we are saying night soil, it contains human excreta. Night soil has a very good fertilizer or manure value. And when we are saying that it contains human excreta, then we are concerned with odor. But it is totally stabilized manure without any offensive odor. Okay? Then sewerage, the term sewerage is not the science of fill in the blank of sewage. What we are saying, collection, conveyance, treatment, or none of the above. See, when we are saying the term sewerage, we are dealing with collection of the wastewater from point source or source of generation or point of generation and transporting it to the treatment plant. It does not contain treatment of the sewage. Okay, that's why when we say sewerage, we are not talking about treatment. Therefore, sewerage is not the science of treatment of sewage. It is the science of collection and conveyance. That is, collecting the waste and transporting the waste. Okay. So, that was all regarding the introductory part of environmental engineering or wastewater engineering. Okay. Do follow us on Spotify, Telegram. Our second YouTube channel is for Hindi viewer, and do follow us on Instagram. All the links are given in description. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.